be the greatest, you can be the best. You can be the King Kong banging on your chest.
You can beat the world, you can beat the war. You can talk the guy, go banging on his door.
You can throw your hands up, you can beat the clock,
yeah.
You can move a mountain, you can break rocks.
You can be a master, don't wait for luck. Dedicate yourself and you can find yourself
standing in the Hall of Fame.
Yeah.
And the world's gonna know your name.
Welcome to My Horse and I, and today I am going to be telling you what I do to take care of my neighbor's cat. Now, my neighbor is just on a little bit of a travel trip. If you haven't seen my travel vlog, I will put an icon that kind of just pops out. I don't know if it's going to come on this side or this side. We'll see. But I'm going to put a little icon to that video because I really enjoyed going to Montana, seeing all those horses. I do apologize that I did cut short on kind of like the horses part, but I really hope you enjoyed the airplane edit, as those views were amazing of the city and the mountains and all the clouds, and I really thought they were really pretty, so I decided I would show it to you, show them to you, show all the really, really cool views to you. And I hope if you saw that video, I hope you enjoyed it. If you haven't seen that video, I'll put an icon, either way. So I am going to be telling you and showing you what I do to take care of Cheeto. So really the basic things are feeding him, making sure there's no ants in his food, because lately, ants have been getting into his food, and it is a little annoying because we don't want him eating ants, and we don't want ants biting him in his mouth if he accidentally eats them, or biting him generally anywhere. So we also don't want the ants eating the food either. So I'll make sure that his water is checked. I just use the filtered water. And I'll make sure his water is checked, and check his food, make sure he has enough food, and make sure there aren't any ants. What will happen if there are ants? We actually have been doing this quite a lot lately because there have been ants in there. We'll take the food out because we don't want the food just staying in there with the ants. So we'll take the food out. And we'll put it in like a colander, and we'll shake it over the sink and make sure that there are no ants left in the food, no ants left in the feeder. Now, he has an automatic feeder, which goes on, I think, 4 times a day. So he gets his food 4 times a day automatically, so we don't have to go up there and go and feed him every time. And once we shake all the ants out of the colander, we spray, I think it's called Simple Green Spray on the sink, because we're just going to get rid of the ants. And then any ants that are outside of the container, we'll get rid of them too. And then we'll put this rub on the placemat. I think it's the rub that, like, I don't know, my mom, like, if I would be congested, she would, like, rub it on my back and, like, on my chest. So that way, like, I think it just clears up congestion. It's called vapor rub. So we'll rub, apparently I think the smell keeps the ants away. So we'll rub that on the placemat on what the feeder is on. So that way, hopefully the ants don't come back. And that's really it with the ants, if there are ants in there. We're trying to figure out a solution to keeping the ants away permanently, because ants keep on getting in his food, and almost every time we go over there, there's some ants over there. So we're trying to clear up those ants. So we'll clear up those ants, and then I'll check his water, and if it's empty, fill it up, of course, because we don't want him to dehydrate. So fill it up. If there is just a little bit, we'll still fill it up because, again, we're not there the whole day. We just come probably like every other day. Sometimes we'll come over there and check on him because he's not like the type of cat that just I think there's like kind of three types of cats. One, the first type of cat is the ones that like absolutely do not like people. They just want to be left alone. Second type of cat, I think they're friendly, but they're not like too, like they don't want too much attention. And then the third type of cat is really, really friendly, really loves people, really loves attention. And I think that third type of cat is Cheeto because he definitely loves attention. He loves it when we're there. He's like, yay, people, you're here, yay. So after making sure that all the ants are gone out of his food, if they're are ants in his food. If there aren't ants in his food, then we're fine with that. Then, and after making sure that he has water, then I'll go over to his litter box and make sure that he has a nice and clean litter box. So I find that the litter box is actually kind of like mucking out a horse's stall because it's literally, like they have sand in the litter box that they go and like, before I started taking care of Cheeto, I'm like, what is, like, how does it work? Like, how does the litter box work? And now I know. You basically, it's basically like mucking out a horse's stall. You have your sand, you have, and then they go to the bathroom, and you really just use that scooper. It has, like, little drainage. Kind of drainage holes for the sand in there, and you use that scooper to pick up the poop, put it in the bag, and if there's any like pee, usually it'll kind of like the sand will be wet and a little bit clumpy, so you can pick up that wet sand with the scooper. Yeah, that's really it to cleaning out the litter box. It's not that much to do. It's not that disgusting. It's really similar to mucking out a horse's stall because it's kind of like with the shavings, you shake out all the shavings and you get the poo. Or if there's wet shavings, you put the wet shavings in the wheelbarrow or the bucket that you might be using. So that's that. And then after I do all that, I'll usually play with Cheeto because he loves to play. He has a couple of toys. He has like a snake toy. He has like this mouse. To me, it looks like a tail, but I think it's supposed to be a mouse. And then he has another mouse toy where he really loves his toys. He'll just play with it. And it's really funny because he does this trick where he has like a toy bin and like a toy drawer that he can actually use his paw and open it. I'll see if I can get a video of that, but I don't know. He hasn't been doing it lately. But to make sure that he doesn't, open it and get out all his toys, because I don't think that would be good. All the toys would be out. You come to see him, all the toys out on the floor. That would not be good. So we put, kind of a case of books in front of it, so that way he can't open it. Even if he tries, he has a book weight in front of it, so we don't have to worry about that. But he also has like a little shedder, kind of like not a de-shedder. I'm like kind of using equestrian terms, but like it just gets all the hair off of him, not all of it, but like it picks up the hair that is getting off of him, like the hair that he's shedding off, which is really cool. I think he thinks it's a toy or something because he was like trying to paw at it. It was super funny. But yeah, that's really all I do to take care of Cheeto.
Okay, so I am sorry for that cutoff. For some reason, the video just cut off, and it cut off at the perfect time, which I'm so glad it didn't cut off while I was speaking in the middle. But this is Cheeto. Say hi. Say hi. Hi. And I thought I'd show you guys a couple clips of me playing with him. I just thought you guys might like to see Cheeto snuggling and playing. Because Because he's super cute, I think. I mean, Cheeto, you've kind of made me a cat person. Thank you. I'm still a dog person, but I'm now also a cat person. So I am actually going to be carving a pumpkin. We'll see if I can do two, but I'm pretty sure I can only do one with the time that I have right now. Ooh, yeah. I'll show you guys a little roll that he just had. Like, if you pet him at a certain spot, he'll just, like, lay down, and he loves it. But, yeah, I thought I'd show you a little of him playing, some clips of him playing and snuggling and being cute. And then afterwards, I will see you to carve some pumpkins. Well, one pumpkin. It is a little bit late to carve a pumpkin for Halloween, but you know what? Let's do it anyway, right? You sleepy, Katie? Okay, so I will see you then. So this is this little baby kitty pose, which I absolutely, ooh, thank you for the kiss, which I absolutely love. And it's just so cute. And whenever I'm feeling sad, I can just hug him. This is the best way to hug him for me. You can literally hear him. I don't know if you guys can hear him, but you can literally hear him purring. His purring is so loud. He just loves attention. He just loves attention. Yeah, so he likes to just brush up on people. He likes to brush up on people. Yep. Do 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 do. 360. Ooh, am I climbing? Am I climbing now? Ooh, okay. So I'm gonna show you guys him jumping through this chair right here. Of course, you can kind of only really see the chair right now, but I'm just getting out a little piece of treat because he loves his treats. I got a different cheeked one. And I don't know if you can see him right now, but he's waiting pretty patiently. He's been a pretty good boy. So, this isn't a how-to video, but for some reason I like to talk in a how-to video. And then he jumped through the chair. So I'll give him the treat now. That was probably off camera, but I'll do a little instant replay of that, so that way you can see him jumping through the chair. But yeah, that's him jumping through the chair. So I thought I'd show you guys that. And then after I give him treats, for some reason, he thinks my hands are treat dispensers. So he'll like look at my hands like, you have any treats on them? No. I want to show you guys his squishy face, because his squishy face is adorable. Don't itch the camera. Don't itch the camera. Come here. Come here. This is a squishy face. Ooh, your squishy face. enjoyed those couple of clips playing with Cheeto. And here's the pumpkin that I have right now. And then I also have, this bag for the seeds because we're gonna put the seeds in the oven and have some pumpkin seeds. And then I have this special carving tool where you can do basic carving, detailed carving, smoothing, and sculpting. I've never heard of sculpting a pumpkin or smoothing a pumpkin, but I think I'm just gonna do the basic carving because this actually is my first time carving a pumpkin, so please don't judge my pumpkin carving skills. But I'm gonna open this up right now. That was really easy to open. And I think, and then I also have this bag to put all the like tools in. Ooh, it's sharp. I just kind of cut myself. So, yeah, we'll see how this goes. I think what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna do like maybe like two triangle eyes and then like a teethy mouth. And then I'll see if I can do a cat for Cheeto. Ooh, wow. I did not expect this to be this hard. Wow. I mean, it's not too hard, but could be a little softer. So I'm gonna open the top, take all the pulp out, and then we can get to carving. Okay, so I now have my top done, and I do apologize that I look a little kind of, I am tired, and I apologize that I look a little like dirty and tired. I actually just had a horse riding lesson like a couple hours ago, and yeah, I'm still in the same clothes, and I smell like horses, and well, now I smell like Cheeto, but I'm just gonna, ooh, let's get this out here. Ooh, I probably should have gotten a spoon to get all the pulp out. Too late now. Oh, wow. Look at that. Wow, look at that. That looks awesome. That, I don't know why I said that. I mean, it looks awesome. It looks like a bunch of roots almost. I'm sorry, I've just never seen the inside of a pumpkin. Most of you probably have, but I don't do that much pumpkin carving. This is my first time carving a pumpkin, so. Yeah, I'm a little bit rusty here, but. Well, really, I'm not rusty, I just don't know how to do it, but I have a pretty good idea, and I'm looking inside the pumpkin is so warm, but I'm gonna get all the pulp out, try and get all these little stringies off, and hopefully that won't take too long, and then it'll be time to carve. As much off as I can. I mean, if it ends up just looking like wet hair, just kind of, I mean, to me it looks a little bit like wet hair on the top. Like, doesn't that look like wet hair? I think I'm gonna keep it like that because otherwise I'm gonna be here all day trying to get that off instead of focusing on emptying the pumpkin itself. But yeah, I don't think this tool is that good. I mean, it's sharp, but it bends really easily. Like, I can literally bend it like this. Not ideal for a pumpkin carving tool, but I think next time I'm definitely gonna use a knife. The inside is so, it's just like, it's so, just a lot more. I thought it was gonna be like kind of more pulpy as opposed to like the stringy stuff. Oh boy. Yeah, I don't know if I want to take out this. I think I'm gonna leave, because I think if I try to take out all the seeds right now and separate it from the pulp, I'm just gonna be here forever. I have something later. I'm gonna miss that. I think I'm just gonna put the pulp that has the most seeds in there, and I'm using my hands. I'm just gonna use my hands now, because why not? Because otherwise that's gonna be forever if I don't use my hands. Oh. So weird. It's like, you know that like stringy confetti stuff? I was actually once at the rescue and this girl sprayed it on me. It's like this stringy confetti stuff. It's like that stringy confetti stuff that I don't even know what's in it to make it like stringy. Look how hard this looks. It's so slimy, but look how hard that looks. Let me come closer. I'm gonna go home. My parents are gonna be like, what have you been doing? But yeah, let it focus. Is it gonna focus? There. It's like, it's a slimy seed, but we're gonna roast it. So I'm putting like all this seed stuff in this, and then, I don't know, maybe I'll just put all the pulp in that, and yeah, but might just do that. But I'm definitely not using that. Yeah, I don't think there's any more of this that I can take off. It's just so stringy, and I don't know, it's just so stringy. Look how much pulp there is. That's not a lot of pulp. Like, I thought there was gonna be so much more pulp, but I think I'm gonna start carving now, and then I don't know if I'm making a huge mistake right now, because I've never carved before, but we'll see if this is a fail or a success. Hopefully it's a success. I am using my neighbor's pumpkin, so thank you, my neighbor, for letting me use your pumpkin. Yeah, it's a nice size pumpkin. I'm gonna have a lot of fun with this. I'll see if I can get like a candle that goes in there, but at the same time, I do live in a hot place, and even if it's at like nighttime, I feel like, I mean, obviously I would turn the candle off, but you might just have to see it non-lit up, but it's not definite, so we'll see. Now, time to use this really interesting carving tool. The bendy carving tool, we can call it that. So, yeah, let's hope for the best, and you will see the finished product soon. Okay, so I've got my first eye. I thought I would just do like one big reveal, but I thought I'd show you guys. So I've got my first very tiny eye compared to the size of the pumpkin. I don't know. Should I make it bigger? I think I'm just gonna leave it. And then what I'll do is just have a really nice big mouth. I'm using this, apparently this side is the smoothing side, to kind of just get this a little bit, looking a little bit nicer. I really wish,
You know what? I'm gonna go inside, grab a kitchen knife, and I will be right back. Okay, so I've got my kitchen knife, and I need to hurry up because my camera's at low battery. But I've got a kitchen knife, so hopefully it'll look a little bit better, be a little bit straighter, a little bit easier to cut into. And I'm gonna finish this up, and then we'll have the big grand reveal. So I changed the face a little bit. I'm still gonna put black over here because I don't want you guys to see it just yet. But I'm like, my back is a little tired. But what I basically have it so I have a cat. Again, you can't see it right now. And then I made a little change to the face because I was kind of just starting to get control of the knife when I started doing the face, when I was starting to get control of this knife. So I didn't have as much control, and then I just kind of improvised and did something a little bit different. But it's not too different, and I think it looks really good. But it's time for you guys to see. So, I have a cat and a face. And 3, 2, 1. Ta-da! So, I have a cat face right here. Obviously, if I had a little bit more time, I would clear out the pulp a little bit. But maybe further on in the week, I might post like a short video of how it turned out. I'll have like a candle in it, and I will show you guys how it turned out. And then I got my pumpkin top here, and I think it's really good that I like made different edges right here so that way I can kind of fit it in. And then I have a Joker face right here with some teeth and a square triangle and a circle eye. But yeah, that's how my pumpkin turned out. Obviously, it's not the best because it's my first time, but I think it turned out pretty good. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you are new to the channel or have not done so, please like and subscribe. I really appreciate it, and I'll see you all next time.
You can be the best, you can be the King Kong banging on your chest.